So Rui, what's the concept of these practice sessions? What's it called first?
First of all, it's called POP Orchestra. P-O-P Orchestra.
Meaning?
Now P-O-P is quite a tongue twister. It's Panjim Open Philharmonic.
Yeah. So
we also do pop music, but yeah, we also do philharmonic or symphonic music.
Yeah. So, and it's open to anyone?
Yeah, it's open to everyone and it's played in the open also.
Yeah.
It's open in more ways than one.
So the concept of openness means that anyone can join in, however young, however inexperienced.
Yes.
Okay.
Theoretically, anybody can join. Only thing, they have to be able to read a few notes.
Yeah.
Because we play two scores.
Yeah.
We play in strict scores.
Yeah. And what do you all hope to achieve over time?
What we have to achieve is we have to entertain the public. That's the main thing. So we the students are encouraged to play in the open.
Yeah.
Generally, they practice in their houses, inside closed rooms, never getting a chance to play out.
Yeah.
So this is a chance to play out. At the same time, you're learning. At the same time, you're keeping people happy. And this is going to be in the municipal garden.
In the rainy season, it's here. But in the
rainy season, we have it here because there's a nice veranda.
That's in Institute Piyadat.
Yeah.
And in the fair weather season.
In season, it will be in the garden.
I see.
Garden.
And at the end, what do you see emerging from something like this?
At the end, we see an improvement in the musical culture of the place. And it has to be a long-term process.
So it's only Western now, but there's no scope for Indian? Or?
We will be playing Indian songs.
Yeah.
But we will play Indian songs in the Western orchestral mode.
Yeah.
We've already got this. We've already written scores. Rocky and I generally write the scores.
I see.
All the scores which we have written.
They are written beforehand.
They
are circulated beforehand.
And they are written for the instrument.
Yeah.
Suppose we are going to have a saxophone, then we write for a saxophone.
I see.
So, suppose we are having the trombone, we write for the trombone.
What's the participation like? How many people and?
On the books, there are now 60 people.
I see.
Who have at some stage or the other come to this orchestra, and it's like that.
What range of instruments?
All sorts of instruments, the brass section, the trombone, the horn, the trumpet, then we've got the woodwind section having the flutes, the clarinets, in the string section there's the violins, there's the guitars, flat strings, and play confidently. Don't worry about it, we're all a supportive audience.
is wholly unfunded and volunteer driven?
Yeah, completely unfunded. It's entirely a voluntary process.
So what kind of support can people give if they are interested?
To make this thing more viable, to make this thing more powerful, I would think that there would be need for professionals in each of these sections.
To mentor youngsters.
Yeah, to mentor youngsters and hold the whole thing together.
But you're basically an IITian in that sense, so what are you doing here?
I'm going to keep IIT out of this.
But you think music is very important in in the life of any society?
Yeah, of course. I think music is as essential as anything else.
Yeah.
When we study history in schools, we don't study to become historians.
Yeah.
We study geography, we don't study to become
geographers.
As well as when we study English and grammar.
Yeah.
We are not all going to be novelists.
Yeah.
So we have to study music just for the sake of it, because it adds to our character and adds to our life.
Yeah.
And perhaps it might be the only thing which is of value when you've got everything else.
Yeah.
When you've got everything else in the world, probably music will be the only thing of value. So you can eat so much, you can drink so much. Yeah. Music you can have unlimited.
And
you can have it till you're very old also.
Thank you and all the best.